Disclaimer: the following analysis is based on preliminary data and limited visual observation, so it may not be 100% accurate. Bear this in mind, please. Having said that, here are all four ASRock motherboards, this time from the highest to the lowest tier. The X670 Taichi is an 8-layer ATX board with 8 plus 8 12V pins and a power design sold as 24 plus 2 plus 1. Are they all real phases, or are the V-core ones in parallel or even doubled? At the moment, I don't know. Nor do I know the specifications of the PWM controller and power stages. We shall see at a later date. Anyhow, they are cooled down by a finless heatsink, which should also embed a 3cm fan. Moving on to the expansion slots. There are two PCIe 5x16, with the second one wired to 8 lanes, and a reinforcement on both, as well as on the 4 DDR5 slots. Alongside them, there's one M.2 PCIe 5 socket, while the 3 Gen 4 ones are located around the PCIe 5 slots. Instead, the 8 SATA ports are here, on the right side. Now, the internal headers. 7 Fan plus 1 pump, 4 RGB, 3 of which addressable, 2 USB 2, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1, and 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2x2. The board is also equipped with a debug code display instead of debug LEDs. Or, at least, I cannot see them anywhere. Finally, let's check its back panel. BIOS flashback and clear CMOS buttons. One HDMI of unspecified version. 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1. 5 USB 3.2 Gen 2. Two of which should be better for the latest mice and keyboards with high polling rate, but who really knows? And two USB 4 Type-C with Intel Thunderbolt 4 support too. Intel also provides the controllers for both LAN options. Specifically, a killer AX1675 for wireless 6E plus Bluetooth 5.3, and a killer E3100 for wired 2.5 gigabit per second. The three audio ports are handled by an ESS9128DAC, in combo with a Realtek ALC4082 codec. I'd like to point out that the Taichi is also available with a marble-like skin, named after the town here in Italy, where a well-known type of marmo is quarried, Carrara. This is so tacky that I love it. Then comes the X670E Steel Legend. Compared to the flagship, the V-core phases of this ATX model are now reduced to 16. But, thankfully, no fan is built into the VRM heatsink. Clearly, the downgrades don't stop here. Among the most significant ones, the PCIe 5x8 is replaced by two bare PCIe 3. Wired to 1 and 16 lanes respectively, the debug code display by LEDs, and the two USB 4 Type-C ports by a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C, and a display port 1.4, I guess. Staying on its back panel, this mob also trades for USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, including the two special ones, for three more USB 3.2 Gen 1 and four USB 2. Both Intel and options for an unknown Wi-Fi plus BT module and a Realtek Dragon 2.5G, and the 4082 codec for a 1220. Sadly, while yes, it gets an extra Realtek 1G chip, it drops the ESS DAC along with the clear CMOS button. As for onboard losses, one M.2 heatsink, one fan, and one pump headers are missing. But, above all, the Steel Legend seems to have only 4 SATA ports. Next, there's the X670E Pro RS, a board with 4 less 12V pins and 2, or 1, fewer V-core phases than its higher tier, featuring a strange PCIe configuration. In fact, it swaps the previous PCIe 3x16 slot for a Gen 4x1, upgrades the other PCIe 3x1 to Gen 4, and also adds an M.2 PCIe 3x2 socket without an heatsink. Speaking of storage, this Mobo gets an additional 2 SATA ports as well. As for the other differences, they are rather minimal. It loses the Realtek 1G LAN and the 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, whereas it demotes the USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C to Gen 2, and the 1220 codec to 897. Finally, the X670E PG Lightning. Since its best available image is very pixelated, partially covered by a banner, and even lacking the back panel, I will have to report less information than usual. Apparently, this board should have the same power delivery as its big sister, but an even weirder PCIe layout. It manages to squeeze two PCIe 4x16 slots below the single lane one, then it removes an M.2 PCIe 4 socket, halves the bandwidth of another, but in turn doubles the bandwidth of the Gen 3 one. Oh, there's also an unpopulated M.2 key socket for a Wi-Fi BT module of your choice. To conclude, we can see that the Lightning only features 4 SATA ports just like the Steel Legend, and the DDR5 slots are not reinforced. Not that it matters much. Now, if I were in the market for an X670 motherboard, which would I buy from ASRock? Using the same criteria as the two previous analyses, i.e. the presence of at least one PCIe Gen 5 slot and the debug code display, I would necessarily have to opt for the Taichi. And I actually like it a lot, for three reasons. The two USB 4 ports support Thunderbolt 4. The two special USB ports beg me to be tested. And the Carrara reskin is beautifully ugly. However, if we were to believe the rumors, it would cost around €600. Too much for my taste. All of these with a VRM fan to boot. Among the remaining three boards, I honestly don't know whether and what I'd get. Due to other design choices, none particularly stands out. So yeah, I'd most likely wait for the B650 lineup. If you prefer to compare these Mobos yourself, you will find a spreadsheet in the video description that includes the other vendors as well. Because this is still a work in progress, please let me know if you find any mistakes. Next Monday, I'm gonna show you the ASUS lineup, so don't forget to subscribe. Fare you well for now.